Hello and welcome to Among Us. Today we're listening to Kevin Wilson. So sit back, relax, enjoy the video and enjoy the music.
Flipped it on its edge, but he just casually got up, walked around, then ripped off all the legs. Then one by one he smashed the cuss cross Snakey's ugly head. If his brain weren't so well padded, he'd be dead. But Snake just shook his skull and blinked a bit and slowly looked around. Then chucked a right that put a knock to War Memorial down. And the force of it sent Lofty flying, crashing through the wall. Now there's a doorway where there weren't one there before. He landed ass up in the shithouse with his feet stuck in the air, with bricks and shit and broken glass and paper everywhere. And caked in that and crap, he ripped the dunny off the wall. And armed with that, fuck all brains went back for more. He slammed that dunny over Snakey's head, shattering it to bits, peppering him with porcelain and splattering him with shit. And there was teeth amongst the muck and shit. Whose they were, you couldn't tell, but it looked like Lofty lost an ear as well. And Snake's right eye was swollen shut from where he got one art. Van Dinkum made it look as black as Ernie Dingo's ass. But with all the pieces missing and with all the blood and gore, they weren't as fucking ugly as before. There was flesh and hair and skin and bone and blood splashed on the wall. And them two bastards wallowing in it, rolling across the floor. And the publican just scratched his balls, wondering, looking round, should he clean the bastard up or burn it down? Most clues you see turn out to be a win or loss or a draw. But collective, I've seen both opponents lose the fight before. And I heard Snooker say to Lofty as they crawled towards the bar,
"Fuck you, Snooker, want a game of darts?"
It was the front bar, Feverbrain, non-fatal fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one give two knobs a goat shit who was wrong or right. At the front bar, Feverbrain, non-title fight. It was the front bar, Feverbrain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one give two knobs a goat shit who was wrong or right. At the front bar, Feverbrain, non-title fight. It was the front bar, Feverbrain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one can do loves it, don't you do? Of me time, buying dinner and wine, and me money on flowers and lollies, only to find that what's on me mind isn't on hers and she's sorry. So I've made up some lines that save wasting time and keep me from blowing me brass. I'm ever so cool, I just prop on the stool right next to hers and I ask, "Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I feel your tits? Or would you show them to me? 'Cause you got a nice head and you look pretty honest. So me face will be leaving in quarter of an hour. I'd like you to be honest." When you first meet a Sheila and the bullshit you gotta go through, like calling her up and telling her you love her when all that you'd love is just a screw. But she wants to hold hands and you to meet her old man and sit around for hours and talk. But me new method is you just cut through the shit and get down to the goodies straight off. Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I feel your tits? Or would you show them to me? Do you sleep in the nick? Do you give head very often? If we can decide your place or mine, we can fuck off then. the next time you see a good-looking Sheila, and you'd give a week's pay to hold her. Don't sit acting dumb, just front her full on, and drop a few lines that I told you. This new method of mine might not work every time, but then again, no method will. I've been spat at and slapped, and needing the knackers, but then I got a few fucks as well. Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I spin your tits? Or would you show them to me? If the answer is no to me questions above, then be a good sport and give me the name of a girlfriend who does.
Cider ever made, and their slogan was, gotta have a Dickens cider every day. And I'd sing along with their radio jingle, and although I'd never tried it, couldn't wait till I was old enough to try my first Dickens cider. cider. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Mother Nature's picked me up. Feel good, tonic, fix it up. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. I had my first Dickens cider when I was 17, and me girlfriend at the time never had a Dickens cider either. We fumbled till we got the top off, and when we finally did, it spurred all over her face and hair and dress and down me leg. From then on in, we had a Dickens cider on every single day, and a quickie Dickens cider when I dropped her at a gate. But she blabbed and told her mother, and the next thing that I knew, found out that her mother loved a Dickens cider too. Dickens cider, gotta have a Dickens cider. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Mother Nature's picked me up. Feel good, tonic, fix it up. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Dickens cider before breakfast is a great start to the day. Dickens cider right on bedtime, and you'll sleep like a baby. 69% proof stress relief for women and for men. Even my old man enjoys a Dickens cider now and then. It's medicinal and healthy, and it's guaranteed to work. So before you see a doctor, try a Dickens cider first. Puts a positive bounce back in your step, your eyes will sparkle a little brighter. And remember, any time's a good time for a good stiff Dickens cider. Dickens cider, gotta have a Dickens cider. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Mother Nature's picked me up. Feel good, tonic, fix it up. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. Gotta have a Dickens cider every day. The bus dropped them back at the barbie from a girls' night out on the town and from amongst the
Right, I'm going to end this video here. I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit that bell for notifications. And there'll be more Among Us tomorrow. And until then, I will see you all again. Goodbye.